to slow down. Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. Oh my gosh, guys, I just want to say it is hot. I don't know what's happening in Joburg today. I don't know why, out of the blue, I thought we were leading towards winter, but it is freaking hot right now. And I'm obviously have these light, it's just a ring light, but like it is contributing to the heat. I do have a drink on standby. This is some gin and some grapefruit tonic, berries and lemon. Get you some. Anyway, thank you so much for coming back to my channel. As you can see from the title of the video, I am doing a luxury unboxing. I'm super, super excited. I love shooting these and I love the engagement that comes out with these. With every one that I've done, I feel like we're all just excited about it just as much as I am. So yeah, I just was like, can't wait to do another luxury unboxing. And guess what, guess Hannah, because it was my birthday, gifts, guess Hannah. Anyway, we're gonna be unboxing some of my current favorite items. I don't want to even say too much before we start grabbing the pieces, but if you are going to like this video, which I hope that you are, please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel if you haven't, and comment down below, because I know there's a lot that we have to unpack, baby. Okay, let's get right into it.
I just want to say this again, it's hot, and this hair is hot.
By the way, this hair is from Dolce Looks on Instagram, but they do have a store in Sandton. But there will be a vlog where I actually take you guys with where I get this whole hair done and whatnot, okay? But this video is not about that. This video is about my birthday gifts, and I'm just gonna get into it and unbox it and tell you guys all about the details and whatnot. We're gonna be unboxing my favorite luxury brand, Louis Vuitton. We're gonna be unboxing some vitamin C Louis Vuitton. Guys, isn't it crazy how last year around this time, like last year around my birthday, I was unboxing another Louis Vuitton item, and like I said, this is my favorite brand, and here we are a year later, we're unboxing some more Louis. I'm genuinely so happy. But yeah, I've got two items here that I've been itching to get, because you know, I'm not a big luxury girl, but I am into luxury. There are some pieces that I get excited about, and I'll just, you know, keep it to myself, or maybe I'll tweet about it. And these items are some of the things that I've mentioned. One of the items is actually something I had been yearning for since last year, where I actually went and tried out. So I was like, this year, it's time. And I'll tell you guys the full story, like of like the process of me purchasing with each item. Okay, so let's start with the first piece. So obviously, as you guys can see, you get the paper bag, big paper bag. We've got a box. We got a big box of Louis Vuitton. We're just gonna put it here. And then we've got a little box of Louis Vuitton. I obviously have opened everything, guys, because like, yeah, the excitement and everything. But yeah, we've got two boxes that we're going to be unboxing. And then I did get some cute stuff as well. Hold on one second. Okay, so I did get some a few goodies that I'm gonna probably show you guys first, just to get those out of the way. When I was purchasing, the lady who was assisting me was nice enough to give me some little goodies. I feel like this is, I don't know why the other people hadn't given me these, because if it's about money, my other purchase there was more than what I've purchased here. But I guess it depends on who's assisting you, because guys, I've been to LV a couple of times where I've had like different experiences where I'll go there and the person is like, you know, like maybe if I'm saying I want this particular bag, and then they start
like pushing me towards another, which I understand, because I mean there are sales people and they do want to make a big sale, but if I'm getting a big bag, why are you trying to twist my mind into something else? And then like, okay, they say whatever you want is not available. I've had like different experiences at LV, but this was the first time that I was getting like an amazing experience with someone who was patient, someone who was willing to serve, someone was allowing me to try different things. Like a really gorgeous lady, her name is, I think her name was Tammy. Like colored lady, gorgeous. I'm not saying go there and reference my name, but like if you do go to LV in Santon and you come across this colored lady, her name was like Tammy, something like that. Great service, Shim. I'm not even gonna lie, like great service. But I even told her that maybe the next time I go there, I'll like specifically request for her, I guess. Some of the goodies that I got, she threw them inside of the paper bag. This is the first thing I got from as a goodie, a little goodie. It's their little like booklet. It's called The Book, the Louis Vuitton book, I assume. It just has like all their amazing items. There's also like fashion. I have this scarf. This is the scarf that I already have. It's like some of their pieces and stuff like that, guys. I'm absolutely so, I don't know, like I'm so happy to have this. I even have already found a place to put it as decoration in my apartment. Like I'm already making this a, like some sort of deco at my place. Like just some of their items. I don't know, maybe you can look through it if you want to get some info for your purchases. I'm sure there's like history of the like Louis Vuitton or whatever designs they're leaning towards. Look at how beautiful this handbag is, guys. Look at this. Yeah. But I was really, really happy that she threw this in. Like, I don't even know if it's free or not. I don't even know, but it probably is. Maybe they do give this out as like a gift. I don't know, but I'm happy to have it, baby. Another thing that she did give me were these perfume samples. Also, I've never gotten perfume samples from LV, and I figured maybe I should ask for them, but I wouldn't really also have the guts unless I'm going there with someone. But if I'm going there alone, I probably wouldn't ask for the samples. So I got four of these, and it's two of each. This is their Stella Times, Louis Vuitton Stella Times fragrance. I don't know if I should smell it for you guys now. I'm trying to open it so you guys can see. It's sample, so like you can't really expect too much. So yeah, this is the Stella Times little sample, and she gave me two of these. It's a very fresh, not too sweet, but it's kind of feminine. I don't want to spray it out because this sample, guys, I don't want to waste it. But I'm so happy that she gave me these samples, because again, I've never gotten samples. So I also got Spell On You. I've seen this fragrance a couple of times there, and I think I have sort of like tested it. And I don't know, because you know when you go there, you see so many things, you see so many other fragrances. Or by the time you decide on what you want, your senses are confused because you've smelled so many different things. But I've seen this fragrance there a lot. Why could I smell it? I'm gonna have to spray this. Oh, this is a good one. This is a good one. I think I've smelled this somewhere on someone or something. I'm sure it's pretty popular. Oh, oh, beautiful. Oh, this is stunning. Oh my gosh. Guys, no. I don't want to get into perfumes because, you know, I love perfumes. But shout out to Tammy at Santon City Louis Vuitton. Girl, you did something, okay? Thank you so much. Okay, and then obviously in the box, we just have like receipts and stuff. Yeah, we just have receipts. Just some receipts. So let's do the actual unboxing. So I'm gonna start with our little box over here. You should already know it's some jewelry. I'm so excited about this because I've been wanting this. These earrings have been popular for a while, and I was a bit hesitant at the beginning. I was very just like, It's also because I wasn't really like a huge jewelry person. I've been like very held back when it comes to jewelry. I started off with like watches, then I got to earrings, and now I'm doing like neck pieces, whatever, bracelets, whatever. I want to get. So I'm only now feeling like, okay, I really want to tap into, you know, jewelry. And of course, you know, if I can have a little bit of luxury jewelry, because those are timeless, those are investments, you know. So I had to go ahead and get the Louis Vuitton hoop earring. I want to see from the receipt, what do they actually call them? It's written B.O. Louis d'Or. The receipt is written B.O. Louis d'Or. So I don't know if that's the actual name, but when I did call in before I went to Satin City, I asked them about the hoop earrings, and they just called them like the LV hoop earrings, and then they come in gold. They also come in pink from what I heard when I called them, and then they said they have the GM, and the GM is usually like, it's quite bigger than this. It's like the big size. That's the big size of hoop earrings, which is, I think, is the one that is most popular, the most people have, honestly. Like, most people do have the GM size. That's the bigger size. But when I got there, I saw the GM, and when I tried it on, because you can't really try on like luxury jewelry, because they don't really have a way of sanitizing it. So I had to like just place them on my ear, and I just felt like they were overwhelming for me. And guys, if you know me, probably you don't, but like, I take my time with things. So I'm not someone who goes for the jugular in general. Like, I need to really pace myself. And when I did like place the earrings against my look, or when I was there, I just felt like it was gonna bore me a lot. It was gonna feel overwhelming very often. So I was like, okay, what else do they have? And they told me that they had the nano. So obviously the nano was a little size. And when I did look at the nanos, they seemed like too small. So I asked them, is there like a cross in between? Like, is there something that's in the middle? And they were like, no, they only have the GM and the nano. So I was like, I know the GM is gonna overwhelm me, and I love these earrings so much that I don't want to not wear them. Because I've seen a lot of people on Instagram who wear them pretty often. And I'm not saying like people don't know how to dress them, but people be wearing them to the club. People will be wearing them for lunch, for golf tournaments, for going to the market and stuff like that. And I feel like sometimes they do look overbearing, and I don't want to seem like I'm trying too much. I love these earrings, but I also want to always have the confidence to wear them without looking like I'm trying to say, yeah guys, I'm wearing Louis Vuitton earrings. Do you get what I mean? Maybe I'm overthinking it, but like, I have seen how bulky and like overbearing they look on other people. So I was like, maybe let me try the nanos. I was even willing to buy the studs, because the studs are gorgeous. They just have the LV. Those were absolutely beautiful. I also saw the studs at Gucci, just GG studs, which were a lot, you know, less pricier. They were also an option for me, but you know guys, like, when you love LV, you want LV. So I did see the Gucci GG studs, but then I was like, I want LV. And then I felt like, okay, if I'm not, I don't want to get the studs at LV just yet, but I don't want the GM because they seem too big. So if I decided, you know what, let me try on the nanos. And it was a win, guys. Like, we were sold. They're tiny, so I don't know if you guys are gonna see them properly. We have this little dust bag. How cute is that? And then we have my beautiful pair of Louis Vuitton hoop earrings. Oh guys, even the gold, like the quality of that gold, it is so striking. It is just like a moment. Like, these earrings on their own are just like a moment. And okay, I'm obviously wearing hoop earrings, but these are from Shein. But can you see the definition, like the quality of this gold? Like, this is a purchase I will never ever 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 ever, ever regret. And if I were to lose these, I'm gonna cry for 40 days. because I never want to lose this. Hey guys, you're in the name of Jesus. But these are so, so, so beautiful. I love them so much. So, 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 so much. I've already worn them and I've posted them on Instagram because I'm like, ah. I'm joking. But yeah, I absolutely, absolutely love these. I'm happy with the size as well. I thought I was going to regret not getting the GMs, but I'm happy with this. Like, I'm happy with it because these I can wear anywhere, anytime, work, to the club, for a dinner, for a lunch, for a casual day. Yeah, but not, like, they just make so much sense for me. So I'm really, really, really happy with these. Obviously can't try them on the video because I'm wearing these ones. So yeah, maybe in another vlog you guys will see me wearing them. But these are my beautiful earrings. This is my first birthday gift that I absolutely am obsessed with. Okay, I'm choosing not to speak on the price of these and the next item. Not for anything in particular, honestly. If someone asks me in the comment section, maybe I might share. But I just feel like, in case I do more of these, I don't want to be divulging, like, pricing and stuff like that. Because, you know, hey guys, I don't want to be apologetic when it comes to stuff like this. And whenever I do watch this kind of videos, I see so many people like, oh, I'm so sorry, the economy, no, 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 no. Which is valid, like, which is super valid. But also, you know, and the other ones are to me, guys. I really appreciate my gift, as vain as it might seem or anything like that. But, like, I'm very happy with my earrings. Now we're gonna unbox the bigger box. I want to give you guys a bit of a backstory. So initially when I went to LV, and initially, like, when the year started, I had my heart set on a bag. I felt like I'm absolutely obsessed with my Neverfull, and if I'm gonna get another bag, I want something maybe smaller, maybe more outgoing, because I can never go out with my Neverfull, yeah, but so, but I do have the, you know, the little pouch that you get inside the Neverfull. So I love that bag, even for that purpose, that it's multifunctional. I absolutely love it. So I was like, I need, like, a going out bag, like something a little small, and I don't really have a black bag. So I was like, let me get a black bag. So I had my heart set on the Alma BB in the Epi black leather, right? So it's just plain black. And it has a bit of, like, striped texture. I did take a picture of the bag, if I can place it here or something. I don't know if you guys would be interested in seeing it. But I have my heart set on that. But when I got there, the BB just seems so small. Like, I understand that the BB is like the baby. And then there's, like, yeah, well. But I was like, it is so small. And for the price point, I was just like, this is a lot, guys. Like, this is a lot to part with for a small bag. Although this is a gift, I just also wanted to be wise with my purchase. Not to say that I couldn't just get the bag, but, like, the fact that I was also questioning it for me was just like, mm-mm. So I asked the lady to, like, give me some time, like, show me some options. And obviously, guys, at Louis Vuitton, a lot of things are expensive, and you can go there with a certain budget, and you're not gonna get that many options within that budget, because the prices really just go from 0 to 100. So I was just like, you know what, let me go look at some shoes. So I went and looked at some shoes, and I bumped into an old lover of a shoe that I tried on last year, and it was really hyped last year. Like, it was really, I was seeing a lot of people, like, wearing this shoe on Instagram. I was seeing it hyped a lot. I tried it out around the time, but I had my heart set on something else around the time last year. And I'm someone, guys, who doesn't just do things. Like, things need to really feel right. So at this point, I was looking at the shoe and I was like, this is it. This is the time. It's time for me to get this shoe. So the receipt says, these are the Bomdia Flat Comfort Mules. Okay, so yeah, I actually checked their website, and they are actually called the Bomdia Mules. Here they are in their glory. I haven't even touched these. Like, I put them on my foot just to be like, okay, they are here. They are really mine. So yeah,
yeah, let's just unbox. So they do come with their dust bags, and I'm just gonna take them out. As you can see, I'm so happy with this purchase, guys. Like, I took pictures of them yesterday and I just kept staring at them like, wow, you're so perfect. Okay, so here they are. Just gonna take out these dondons, lama pep. I'm gonna show you guys, but I also want to place some emphasis because there was a pair of these mules, ne, there that I tried on, and those are the normal mules. They have done like an upgraded version, they've made an upgraded version of those mules that everyone had, I think, last year. And they've added this, like I don't know what to even call this, like this textured like foot ndondoni. I don't even know what to call it, guys, but the lady showed me that the ones that you are trying on and the ones that most people have don't have this detailing like underneath, although it's at the bottom, but like you think that it doesn't matter, but they've zhuzhed it up, okay? And but they're still the same price. When you go there, you can still get either, because the only reason why I got these advanced ones was because they had a 5, but the 5 was very tight, so I had to get a 5.5. So these are the flat comfort mules that I got from Louis. You guys, look at these. Like, look at these. And I love the changes that they've made between the old mules versus these ones, because also the old mules had buckles on both belts, and these ones actually come with this, I don't know, is it a scrunchy belt? But yeah, that's one of the changes that they've made with this shoe, and I'm just so happy to be one of the people who get this new version with this detail at the bottom, and instead of the two buckles, we have this little, it gives it more subtlety, in fact, than having the gold buckles on both sides. I'm not saying it's a bad thing to the people who do have those gold buckles, but I just like the subtlety that comes with having this type of belt and then the gold buckle at the bottom. You can adjust both. It's like the same like idea and quality of the shoe, but you just have it, you know, a little bit styled and zhuzhed up, you guys. I am so in love with these. I got this in a 5.5, but they fit perfectly. It's not as tight as what a 5 would have been, but it's like, and I honestly am glad that I got this instead of the bag, because if I'm keeping it honest with you guys, I've been abusing my Gucci sandals. Like, those girlfriend Gucci sandals, I've abused them, and apparently these are like the wifey. These are like the wifey sandals. It's like imama sandals. Like, yeah, well, umama wa muzi. Ah, I'm joking, guys. I'm not a mama of any muzi, please. But I'm so happy with these. They make me so happy. Like, even the day I wear them, I just know that I'm gonna feel hella confident. Like, imagine if I get like a belt to match with these, so I can wear them with a belt, or like a smaller kind of bag that will match with these. Like, it makes so much sense. Ah, absolutely happy with this purchase. Honestly, both of the things that I got from LV, I'm just like content. Like, I'm super happy with, also with the price point, guys. You know, it's a lot, and I think with these two things that I've gotten, you could get one bag from LV. But now I think I've gotten a value of my money, because now I have an everyday sandal that I can be comfortable with, I can be confident in. It's, you know, it's like, it's my favorite brand. So I'm super content with these. Just need to adjust the belt so that they don't look so bulky, but these are absolutely stunning, you guys. I'm super happy with my purchase. Yeah, if uli mama, you know what you need to do.
Anyway guys, thank you so much for watching this video. I really do hope that you really enjoyed this video. Shout out to Panga Delam for these beautiful gifts, and I really enjoyed my birthday gifts and my birthday in general. But don't worry, there will be a vlog that shows a little bit of what I got up to around the time of my birthday and how I celebrated, so be on the lookout for that. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like, comment and subscribe. I love you guys. Bye. Something I can't feel.